Okay, so yesterday we started the discussion of sequential logic elements, which are essentially some circuits that implement sequential functionality. What do you mean by sequential functionality? They have some concept of memory, right? So the circuit element will retain its value even in the absence of input under certain conditions. Okay. And in that way, we can sort of use this as a way to store information or a state of the circuit for extended periods of time. And this sort of forms the basic building block of circuits such as finite state machines, which in turn essentially bring about a whole new level of complexity in terms of the kind of circuits that you can actually implement. Right? So, in a regular combinational logic element, the kind of timing metrics that we are interested in are essentially the propagation delay . There is also a similar equivalent value called the contamination delay. Now this is much less discussed in general. Right? The contamination delay essentially says what is the minimum delay after which the output can change for a given change in input. Okay? For the most part, we are not really concerned with this value. The contamination delay is something which, after all, it's only the minimum delay after which something can change. For the most part, we find that this is not something of interest. It becomes interesting specifically when we consider certain kinds of sequential circuits, right? In particular, when we are trying to find out whether there is a violation of the hold time constraint in sequential circuits. So, the contamination delay is defined for all kinds of logic elements, including combinational logic, but is less commonly considered than the propagation delay itself. Apart from this, you have the rise time and the fall time. Okay. These are defined as the sort of 10% to 90% rise time or the 20% to 80% rise time, and correspondingly for the fall time. Right. So, similarly, there are some metrics that are defined for sequential elements as well. The simplest kind of sequential elements that we can think of is one which has one controlling input, we'll call it the clock, one data input, we'll call it D, and one data output which we'll call Q. Okay. Now, as we'll get to the further classification in a short while, but you are already familiar with the basic idea of edge triggered versus level triggered. Right? Edge triggered means that the output is sensitive to changes in the clock. That is only when the clock goes from 0 to 1 or from